this small video how to basically discharge this compressor, drain it, and pretty much this is a daily routine. If you're using air compressor or air tools, this is a compact compressor, so if you use a setup like that to run your air tools, pretty much you will have the same daily routines. So let's get started. And as you can see, now it's pressurized. So first of all, pretty much first thing we are going to turn it off, and then we still have pressure in the tank, so we need to basically drop the pressure. We can use this valve, and basically this is a typical way of doing that. Just pull this ring and the air will come out. What I'm going to do, and what I'm typically doing, I'm going to discharge this compressor using basically air gun to make sure we don't have water in this house. And I suspect it will be full of water, since this house is on a concrete floor, and this concrete floor is it's cold, but the air in the tank is hot, so the water we have a condensation problem within this hose. And then more sophisticated setup, people typically add water filter. People typically add water filter in their setups. We have water filter on the compressor. So that's why I drain this water pretty much after each use. Let's turn this thing off. And it appears we don't have much water. Great. It appears we don't have any water in the house, since it's already cooled down, so probably this water is gone.
How to drain this sink using basically hose, rather drain rather air drop valve.
Actually, I would like to make sure that there is no excessive amount of water in the line. So basically I drop the most of the pressure through air line using this simple air gun. And now we have tank pressure around 35 psi, and pretty much it's okay. We can disconnect the line. So, and it's much less noisy if you do this on low pressure, since there's a bunch of air in this hose, and this air is compressed to, well, like 100 psi or whatever settings you have for your line. Then the next step is to drain this water oil filter. Basically, it has this little knob, and I already drained that, so we don't really see much water here. We see some fog, but it's fine. It has 90 psi limit actually. All right, the line is empty. We've drained the line, so pretty much we just put this hose together. And all right, now we have something. Now we need something to protect your hose from dust and all this stuff. I use just small plastic bag, and the hose for our new hose we have. We have this nice spot. This is a hook for bicycle water bottle, which I don't really use. It's very handy. Okay. Now we have air compressor. Now we have air compressor here, and it still have some pressure. As you can see, the tank pressure is 35, and line pressure. Okay, we don't have line. Line is disconnected. There is a valve to drop the pressure. It's North Star compact compressor. It's right there. So basically, we need to pull this, and this valve is being used for as an emergency as well. It shouldn't allow pressure to build up more than actually tank can handle safely. So it's not a good idea to pull this when your tank is fully pressurized. But I mean, it's fine, but it will be really noisy. Now we have 35 psi, so it will be much less noise. So typically I just drop the pressure to probably like 25-20 psi using this valve. So it's fine, you can see the tank pressure is 25. And then we definitely have some water in the air tank, and we need to drain this water using this drain valve. So make sure you have pressure around 20-25 something, and then you should drain your tank. Basically I will unscrew this valve, and
it will drain the rest of air and will drain the water from the bottom of the tank. I typically store this compressor with open drain valve. You should be very careful, this thing is heavy. Just to make sure you remove all water from the bottom of the tank. And you can see this is for just a couple of hours of use. We have so much water. And we have this nice bag to cover this compressor. That's it. I don't close drain valve to make, I would like to have this tank fairly dry. Okay, that's it. Thank you for watching.